guys. So today is really exciting for me. I am going to go to a matcha place. A while ago, I found out that there is a matcha bar here in Copenhagen. I don't know why I didn't come across it until now, but I thought, you know what, I have to go there before moving. So yeah, the place is called Matcha Mike, and basically it's a shop that sells matcha products and matcha drinks and food. So yeah, I will be going there with a new friend later today. But first, I'm going to visit a small Japanese shop that I also heard about. Honestly, I have no idea why I haven't gone yet. But yeah, I think it looks really cute. They have a lot of Japanese things there. It doesn't look like they have any sweets or drinks, so I guess it's mostly things they have. But yeah, that's basically my plan for today. Just exploring in the center of the city. So yeah, let's go. So we made it to the center of the city, and behind me right here, I found boutique Taeko. So yeah, let's go in and check out the shop. Taeko, and they had so many cute designs, Japanese bowls and cups and cooking stuff. But yeah, I got to speak some Japanese, and the lady in there was really nice, so really recommend you go there. There's quite a lot of people in there now, so I decided to go out, but I need to head to my other appointment now, so I will see you guys soon. So I just made it to the next stop. This is Matcha Mike, and yeah, I found it a while ago, but I didn't really have the chance to go there. But yeah, now I'm here and I'm meeting a new friend here in like 10-15 minutes, so I'm really excited to try their matcha. So we just finished our matcha latte. I'm here with Michela.
Hello!
We're just going to look around this area because they have a lot of Japanese, Asian shops here, so I really want to check it out. The first one is bento. I just saw it and looked really cool, very Japanese, and they supposedly have bentos.
Yeah! It's more like a restaurant, so they have like lunch bento and dinner bento, so it's like they have like three different kind of meals every lunch and evening. Yeah,
cool. Looks really nice. But maybe it's closed? Yeah.
It's
it opens at 5.
It's closed, open from 11 to 1 or 3 maybe. And then it opens from 5 to 10.
Så gode de er. De har alligevel en del, synes jeg.
Mm, det har de.
Mm, det smager så godt. Og QP mayonnaise. I just got some pocky for my students from today, Kipman. I am now wrapped up and ready to go home in this cold weather. And my brother and sister just reminded me that today is pocky day, 11:11, and I just bought pocky, so that's perfect. But yeah, now I'm going to go home and yeah, I'll try to find some food on the way. I'm back home and I just got myself some cheap noodles for dinner. I had no idea what to eat, so probably eat that and a few vegetables that we have. But I mean, come on, this is Danish noodles and it's so boring compared to Japanese noodles. There are just so many flavors in Japan and these are, well, we have chicken and beef. Hello again, guys. So I thought I would just finish this video off by talking a little bit about where you can find Japanese shops, Japanese things and such in Copenhagen. Japanese food is just as popular in Denmark as it is in other Western countries. Even in semi-small cities, there are lots of sushi places. I think one of the most popular shops for sushi here in Denmark is Sticks and Sushi. You can also get Japanese ramen here in Denmark, and the place that I went to was Ramen Tobiru. Recently, I also found out that there is an izakaya here in Copenhagen. I really wanted to go there, but people say that it's really expensive, so I think I can't really afford it. And yeah, then there are places such as Wagamama. And yeah, I think food-wise, there are lots of options to try Japanese food in Denmark. As for matcha, I have tried Matcha Mike, as you saw in this video. I think you can also get matcha latte at Barrasso and Espresso House, which are coffee places. But yeah, matcha is getting really popular in Denmark, and a lot of people see it as like a super healthy thing to drink, which it is, of course, but it's getting really popular here. Ramen is kind of expensive, but you can get it. I think you can probably get them in Chinese shops and also in Farao Cigar. As for Japanese snacks, such as pocky, you can find them in Chinese shops, such as the one I went to. And also in Tohelane. I don't remember if it was hall number 1 or number 2, but you can find some there. You'll also be able to find mochi if you look around in some of these small shops. But yeah, you should be able to get all of these things that we just talked about. If we're talking more about manga and anime, I know that there are some different shops. I mentioned Farao Cigar, and they have a lot of manga and anime, and they have them in English. I think some in Japanese too. There are also other shops such as Animerch and Fantask. I've only been to Animerch, but as you know, I'm not really that into anime and manga, but I just wanted to tell you if you were interested. Also, in the video where Kat and I went around Copenhagen, I noticed a lot of Japanese books in Arnold Busk, which is a bookshop, and then also Cinema, which we also went to in that video. So go check out these shops if you are interested in finding anime, manga, or Japanese books. That was it for this video. I really hope that you enjoyed it, and if you did, please give this video a big like. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!